Hi my dear friends, welcome to Venus EduTech. In this video I will give you the detailed information about IBPS clerk exam pattern and syllabus. I hope you watched the previous video because the previous video contains the information about IBPS PO exam pattern and syllabus. So if you don't watch it, please do watch it. So let's get into today's video. IBPS clerk exam is a two-tier process, preliminary exam and mains exam. But in case of IBPS PO exam, there are three rounds, preliminary exam, mains exam and interview. But in case of IBPS clerk, there is no interview, only preliminary exam and mains exam. This is the exam pattern of preliminary exam. It consists of three sections: English language, quantitative aptitude and reasoning. English language is of 30 questions of 30 marks in 20 minutes. While quantitative aptitude and reasoning consists of 35 questions of 35 marks in 20 minutes. There is a sectional timing of 20 minutes each in these three sections. And there you will have a total of 100 questions of 100 marks in 60 minutes of 1 hour. This is the overall exam pattern of preliminary exam of IBPS clerk. On the other hand, the exam pattern of mains exam consists of four rounds: English language, general awareness, quantitative aptitude and reasoning. Along with this English language, QA and reasoning, there is a general awareness of 50 questions of 50 marks in 35 minutes. And English language consists of 40 questions of 40 marks in 35 minutes. Quantitative aptitude consists of 50 questions of 50 marks in 45 minutes, while reasoning consists of 50 questions of 60 marks in 45 minutes. So a total of 190 questions of 200 marks in 2 hour 40 minutes. This is the overall exam pattern of mains exam. Now let's get into the exam syllabus of preliminary exam. The syllabus of English language consists of the following: close test, fill in the blanks, para jumbles, para or sentence completion, reading comprehension, sentence correction, sentence improvement and spotting error. In the reasoning ability section, the topics covered are alphanumeric series, blood relation, data sufficiency, distance and direction, inequalities, input-output, order and ranking, puzzles, seating arrangement, syllogism and verbal reasoning. Now, the quantitative aptitude section covers average, data sufficiency, data interpretation, mensuration, number series, permutation and combination, probability, profit and loss, quadratic equation, ratio and proportion, relations, simple interest and compound interest, simplification or approximation, time and distance, and work time and energy. Next, going to the exam syllabus of mains exam. The syllabus is same as that of the prelims exam. Let me read it once again. For English language, it consists of close test, fill in the blanks, para jumbles, para or sentence completion, reading comprehension, sentence correction, sentence improvement and spotting error. For reasoning ability, it consists of alphanumeric series, blood relation, data sufficiency, distance and direction, inequalities, input-output, order and ranking, puzzles, seating arrangement, syllogism and verbal reasoning. For QA, it consists of average, data sufficiency, data interpretation, mensuration, number series, permutation and combination, probability, profit and loss, quadratic equation, ratio and proportion, relations, simple interest and compound interest, simplification or approximation, time and distance, and work time and energy. The additional section called general awareness covers the following: appointments, awards or recognition, banking awareness, books and authors, currencies, important days, important places, GK updates, headquarters, launches or inauguration, prime minister schemes, sports and obituaries. Among these, give stress to the important or the latest news about banking. You must get updated on news of the last 6 months prior to the exam date. This is very, very important. This section will be the easiest one in the mains exam because there is no workout, enough time is there, because you are just delivering what you have read or what you have updated in your mind. So that's all about the overview of IBPS clerk exam pattern and syllabus. If you find any of my videos useful and informative, give a like and share that video with your friends. Also, don't forget to subscribe the channel, and in order to get the notification of my latest videos, press the bell icon as well. See you in the next video with another useful content. Till then, have a good day and thank you.